1 minute remaining.
We're going to be starting the show in about a minute.
Okay.
Did you warn me already?
Yep. We're going to be starting the show in about a minute. I will give you a countdown to where we're going to be live in electrical tech. But the show is about to start. Are you guys recording?
Yeah.
Record.
Record. Let's stream.
20 seconds.
Right now?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh my goodness.
We can record it now too?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so we are officially live. We still have 20 seconds until we start.
20 seconds until we're taking the intro?
My watch is at 1 o'clock.
Is it 10? 9,
10 seconds until we take the intro.
We did. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Intro open.
It is.
Alright, 15 seconds, unmute. Record.
10 seconds.
Unmute, thanks.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hi, I'm Nicole Bickle, and welcome to Career Corner. Each month, we'll be exploring different careers to help you figure out what type of career paths that you have. The career cluster we'll be exploring this month, is construction. Construction has multiple different paths. Some of those paths include construction tech, electrical, HVAC, which stands for heating, ventilation, air conditioning, and refrigeration.
Yeah, keep it on three.
Today, I'm joined by Mr. Herbert from the Builders to tell us a little bit about
him. Keep it on the call. We're looking for
you. It's okay.
I work with the Builder Association in Eastern Ohio. All
right, now you can put it on.
What we do is work with commercial contractors.
We're at the guest intro right now.
That build commercial buildings. Things like your shopping malls, your manufacturing plants.
We are at the guest
schools,
intro right now.
Or the type of work our contractors do. Our contractors are union contractors and work within the building trades to.
What are some of
the construction has changed significantly over the past 50 years. Keeping in mind, construction now is state of the art. Different things are going into the buildings being built with energy efficiency and green source. And things like that. The construction field is very dynamic and changing every day. So,
Q&A.
You know, one of the misconceptions is that the people working within the field don't have a high skill set. And that's the furthest from the truth. Our apprentices that come into the field typically will do anywhere from 3,000 to 6,000 hours in an apprenticeship program before they become a journeyman. So whether that's HVAC or electricians or carpenters, they're learning not only
in the preview, you can go back to level 3,
but they're also learning
from the practice.
So it takes typically 3 to 5 years to get to that point. There's a lot of education that goes into it, and they're very skilled individuals that are working in the trade.
In the preview,
you
put on 3.
Where they are working, what type of schooling and training do they have?
Do you know when they're
going to
switch to the
other side? Once they're hired and accepted as a
just keep it on camera 2 for a little bit.
Mm-hmm. And they'll typically start.
But do you know what question you're going to
put DR2 in preview.
Can you ask the mix effectives after we segue to
Yeah.
No, but I need to let them know because they're going to be part of the segue.
Okay.
So I need to know that they're
going to
be live.
To build upon for their career. But the biggest part happens
just
once they get outside of school and start working hands-on. Keep in mind, they're getting paid while they're working.
Jacob, tell me before you're about to switch to the mixed effect.
Okay.
But they'll learn how to
so I can give them a heads up.
They're already, the audience is already
getting paid. Make sure you're switching cameras like between pauses and stuff
yeah.
like that.
The biggest thing is that they're learning on the job by doing it.
When they come straight into the field, what is like normally the entry level salary for a new worker?
Again, depends on various per trade. But typically, most of the individuals are starting at around the $60 to $18 an hour range, which equates to roughly $30,000 to $45,000 a year. Now, that's not just salary, they're also getting.
I'm not sure when we're going to take the segues, if you're ready.
Which includes healthcare and retirement. And as each step of their progress through their apprenticeship program, they're continually getting raises. And that's typically a base salary. But a lot of times, there's also a lot of opportunities for overtime or special projects that they're working on.
With these special projects that they're working on, what do you think,
I think that's hard for a lot of individuals. The type of individuals that are working in the construction field would like to see some finished product, something that they've accomplished, something that they've built. I'm often with different individuals in the field, and we're driving by a school, or we're driving by an office building. Hey, I put the roof on that, or we built that project, we built that person, we built that hospital. So there's also, a big sense of pride in something accomplished when they finish these problems. It's something that, stands the test of time for years to come.
So I know
that
there's a bunch of people that are confused. I don't know exactly, but what are some of the
equipment that you use
on the job that some students
might be interested in?
I don't know if anybody was like me. I know as a little kid, I always liked watching the construction equipment, the bulldozers, the backhoes, the things like that. And I know my son was the same way growing up.
Don't make it too obvious, but try to see if you can have him stop hitting the mic with his hands.
Our excavators and our equipment, has GPS in it, and it's down to, the smallest detail now when it's raining,
sure, as well.
Moving dirt and building highways, and it's very interesting to see how that's done. Each field, kind of has their own technical equipment.
Do we have any indication of how many questions Nicole has left?
We're doing talent or hazard, or it's electricians or carpenters, and I think carpenters kind of get a general catch-all sometimes, but they're a piece of our pie, the building industry. But there's some very specific trades that use a lot of pretty interesting tools.
Gif lives on.
Especially given the size of the excavating equipment, it can be millions of dollars for one piece of equipment.
I love it. So I know jobs can vary, but depending on the person, what's the average workday for a person who works in construction?
She just has average workday.
She says the last one?
I told her so,
okay.
A lot of companies, a lot of projects are made out there. Most of the construction crews
two questions
start early in the morning.
We have two questions
left.
After this,
I will give you a heads up.
So we have one, two? After this
one? She's on the average workday one.
So they're out there.
Okay.
These two left.
Okay.
They'll finish off their day. They take breaks during the day. Yeah, they do. That goal to get that project done, that completion date that they're working on. So
you
constantly see that buzz that's happening in the construction site.
So is there different type of construction workers?
And keep in mind, in our industry, there's 16 craft trades. Think about what goes into a building. You see the excavation happen where the dirt's being graded and things are moving, but then that structure starts. So you might have iron workers putting up a steel structure, and then a carpenter coming in and putting up the framing, the interior walls, and things like that. And it goes on and on, typically until we're putting in the windows and the doors and the roofers and finishing up the roof. So it's all those different crafts are coming together to make one project work. And you know, behind the scenes is a set of blueprints that tell them, hey, we want this building to look like this.
Oh, wait, it's like
this piece of kitchen. And all those different entities are coming together.
On the last question, tell them to.
So you kind of work on like the outside.
Tell them
on
the last question.
So like, tell me about, like, a little bit about your job and like, to answer about working with the construction.
So I work a lot with the construction programs that we've been asking. And then some other things with union negotiations and health and welfare plans and pension plans. But you know, probably the most satisfying thing I do is the recruitment aspect. We're constantly trying to elevate the amount of people that are coming into the field to fill the need that we have. And I thoroughly enjoy helping those people get into the industry and find that job. And
I keep it on the wide shot, put the robo camera on Nicole, but don't take it.
Well, thank you. I hope that people have questions that they're answering.
Right. When are we queuing the subway?
We actually have a live demonstration
segway.
Done
take
on our TCTC Electrical
too?
Tech Lab.
Thank you very much, Nicole. I'm down here in Electrical Tech with Leonard Adams, a student. So what exactly do you do in this program?
So pretty much we cover all basics of basic electrical wiring, like industrial, residential, and commercial.
Did we get a solar
thing? What's your favorite thing to do here?
My favorite is with the industrial, which is right here, with deals
great.
With commercial.
Take camera four.
This?
Yes. Okay, I'm looking at the wrong thing.
Okay, so what are the job outlets like?
With electrical, there's many different opportunities you can go to. You can go to apprenticeships, you can enroll into college or like trade centers.
And you put on the
Now, I see you have a little project over here. Could you kind of explain what this is?
So pretty much right here, this is for our skills competition. What it does is it has a green light always on until you activate the circuit, and then the red light will come on for 5 seconds. Then after it turns off, all the lights will be off until you reset. All
right, well, thank you. I'll let you finish over here. Let's go talk to your instructor, Mr. Taylor. Hi. So can you go a little bit more in depth on like in this what you do in this program?
Electrical technology, like Leonard said, we do three different types of electrical: residential, your house electric; commercial, or stores, schools; and industrial electrician. I was an industrial electrician, General Motors, until I retired last year. We try to stress, you know, a lot of different fields. You can go to work and have a bad day, and you go home. In this field, if you go to work and you have a bad day, somebody's going to get hurt, so we stress safety. There's a lot of opportunities in this field, everything from wiring aircrafts to wiring houses. We are a member of Skills USA, which is our organization we belong to. They have competitions, as Leonard's finishing up there with his skills competition.
So I see that you have a couple little setup things over here. Could you kind of go in more detail on what these are?
It's brand new for our class this season, or this year, is from Learn Lab. This is a training center. And Leonard and another one of the students decided to wire this up on their own. We haven't even gotten into this yet, but turn it on, see the light comes on. You can control different things. This switch here, and
because
this switch turns on the relay. We learn about relays, motor starters. If we wanted to run this as motor starter, he could start a three-phase motor, put it on a timer, and run from there. Also, something new for our lab this year is this little panel that goes inside of a ceiling panel. And very thin, and we're working with this. This is from LED IQ.
So we're going straight to this, or are we doing this? Right?
It's an LED light.
Okay.
It has 360,000 different combinations of colors. You can also program it to strobe different colors. Or you can start back with just the white and adjust the hue on it. These are going into a bowling alley, and our students are learning how to wire these and the different things with LED.
Wow. All right. Well, thank you very much. That is very interesting. Let's go back here with Leonard to see how his project is.
All right. So I just finished hooking up all the switches over here, which now that it says it's turned on, we can see how it works. As you can see, that the green light is on when the circuit is not active, and
I press the green button, which is our start button. And I'll activate the circuit. After 5 seconds, the green light in here, the timing light will switch. And it'll turn off the red light until I reset it with the black button. And then I can start again.
All right, very interesting. Well, thank you guys both so much for joining me. And let's send it back up to Liv with the 360 cam.
All right, she's on.
You guys are good. Hello. My name's Liv, and I am your VR specialist here at Career Corner.
All right, now, second letter works.
VR is different from the beginning, right? Well, you're half right. VR can be used for a plethora of things, such as virtual hands-on experience, interactive training, and educational purposes. Today, we will be looking into our electrical, HVAC, and construction programs working side-by-side to create a working bathroom.
We'll go to a tech shop.
Here inside the VR,
she'll talk about.
You can see a construction worker and an electrical worker working side by side to power this little electrical car. In his hand, he's holding a little device that can tell him if it's going to work or not.
Because she's going to talk about
shortly,
the website,
he'll
and then
plug it
that's
in,
what we're going to take.
And he'll see if it lights up or not.
No.
Now, I do apologize for the lag, but he's plugging it in. Now, it's not flashing, meaning the electrical socket isn't working. They'll be getting to go through, rewire this entire building, just so we can get to its power that it needs to be. Here, they're working on the vents. This is how the air will circulate throughout the bathroom. Now, let's go back to Nicole for the end of our show.
All right, take it through.
Remember that all of our VR 360 videos are on our Career Corner website. Now with us, we have Mrs. Gensberg, and she's here to talk to you guys about some of the construction industry's careers available in the Santa County area. So there are definitely careers related in this huge field that, we're kind of encompassing under construction in the Trumbull County, but also in the Mahoning Valley area. And I would say a year ago, I wasn't really knowledgeable about that. It was actually getting involved in a project with the Builders Association that increased my knowledge, because I was one of those people that thought construction is that really narrow field, like someone who does carpentry type work. But like Mr. Hartman was saying, there's so many more things to that. And so I think as students, when you broaden your view and you don't just think carpentry, but you think carpentry and you think excavating and you think glazing, like in bricklaying, when you open that up, there really is a great job outlook. So, and that's a question for Mr. Hartman. What is the job outlook like in the Mahoning Valley for this sort of thing right now?
I think it's great right now. We're looking at so much.
You guys are good.
New industry coming into the valley. There's so many factors that involve that. But people within our valley, Mahoning Valley, are really striving to work very diligently to bring that new industry in, create opportunities, create jobs. And with that, the building trades also moves forward. We know within our industry, the building trades, that by 2020 across the nation, we're going to be about 2 million people short in our industry. So that's a significant hurdle that we have to try to overcome, or we're not going to have the staffing, the manpower to be able to complete those projects, be able to complete those jobs. And all those things that I hate to handle.
We missed that opening there for Nicole.
She
wanted to figure out when
the restaurants and the stores and stuff that you want to go see, or what you want to go eat at, or it's places where you're looking to get jobs. Mm-hmm. So the economic forecast for the industry is fantastic at this point, and we're constantly looking to fill roles in the construction industry.
So I think that brings us to the at TCTC to say what's your E, right? Enrolled, enlisted, or employed. So how can the construction industry fit, into those E's? And it really, the neat thing about this industry is it's across the board. And so when we think about enrolled includes those great apprenticeships that Mr. Hartman was talking about. That is on-the-job, hands-on training. That is learning something. That is an aspect of being enrolled. So if you're thinking, you do want that excess, want that training after high school, an apprenticeship is a great way to go. So if you're thinking about an apprenticeship, or someone is thinking about that, the time to start is sooner rather than later, even in those middle school years, because you want to make sure that you are paying attention to the content topics in school that are necessary for that. And then the other thing that's going to be key for getting any of these jobs, or dealing with any of the equipment or anything that comes to it, is being drug-free. That's a really key portion to these jobs, and so I'm making that a priority now, that pledge to be drug-free, and that carrying that through so then you're prepared when you leave high school to enter this, you know, to enter this field. As of right now, they are, like, in middle school, so right now, do they have, like, good resources to look to enter these jobs? Yeah, they're great resources to look to. So if you're thinking about any job, you know, one thing I would say, don't assume you know what the job is. So research it, whether that means you have a family member that you know that you can put yourself in contact with, maybe a grandparent or someone knows something, somebody who works in it, just start the conversation. So, you know, obviously that middle school age, you know, visiting a site or something is maybe not what we're talking about that level, but start to gain knowledge and research it. There are a lot of good, look up an apprenticeship and see what the requirements are. You know, I know you may think, oh, it's really young for that. It's not, because that is going to happen sooner than you think. Figure out, well, what do I need to do? All those things start mattering pretty, you know, matter pretty quickly. And so being prepared and knowing ahead, there's nothing wrong with saying, this is what I want to do and having that goal. And then making sure you're going to do it even in 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, trade.
One of the great places, if they look for those resources, is www.mbskilltrades. It's one of the websites that we put together this year to kind of showcase and house all the different trades. They give a description, give links to the trades, different union pages, along with that, a lot of great videos on the website that will help showcase and explain what some of the trades do.
Okay, well, before we close, I want to say that Career Corner has a website on tctcinteractive.com. If you're interested in that, you should definitely look into that. So thank you for joining us today. Our next episode is going to be on November 13th, where we'll be discussing the manufacturing career cluster, and that includes welding and cutting, machining tech, and our new lab manufacturing. See you next time.
Remember, let it roll for a couple minutes.
Just wait like a minute. Not
a minute or two.
Let's do 3 minutes.
Okay.
Because that's how long it takes for TCTC time,
mm-hmm.
right?
TCTC
yeah.
time is 3 rolls of the outro.
Mm-hmm.
Which I forget how long the outro is.
It's definitely not 3 minutes.
But it's okay. We'll do 2 or 3 minutes. Good job, everybody, especially for the first episode.
Yes.
There were some hiccups, but definitely not a whole bunch.
Not
any that
stop.
Mattered.
But now I have to give it a
football. It'll be like a button. I'm guessing it's like the only button.
No, it's okay, you did it.
There's 2 buttons. One of them's power, one of them's thing. I don't know if you need to.
Yeah, just let it.
Power button, get Duran. Duran knows. Go get Duran.
Duran.
Get Duran.
Get Duran.
Don't hit it. I'll
stop streaming. I was just waiting for the stream.
Yeah. We still have, like, a minute or two.